Hey everybody, tonight I wanted to show you something that Jordan just put together recently. We've been needing something to kind of stabilize our camera a bit, especially when we're out at the racetrack, or even when I'm doing some car videos I may use it. And I've been talking to Jordan about it, so he actually went out to the garage and this is what he came up with. And I've actually already used it already. In fact, if you've seen the drag racing footage from Gateway Motorsports Park, this last video that I did, I actually used this the entire time. Let me show you how we put it together here. Up top, it just has the head off of a tripod. So that gives us a little bit of versatility because you can tilt it, obviously, up and down, or it swivels. So that's kind of nice. And of course, you know, it's got the typical camera mount, so it screws into the bottom of the camera easily. That's mounted by, he actually took the top of the tripod and put it into this steel pipe here. This is actually a hollow barbell that he cut down, and then he put that tripod head in there and then just put a bolt through it so that it can't slip out. Then for this crossbar here, it's just some square tubing. Once again, the tubing comes through here, and then you put a bolt through there to hold it in place. Then we've wrapped it with tennis wrap tape just to give it a little bit of grip. It also covers the ends, so if this would bang into something or touch up against a car or something, it won't scratch it. So we just thought that was a good idea. But we mostly put it on there just so you'd have good grip on there. Then, as you can see, there's more tennis wrap tape going down the handle, because there's a variety of ways you can use this thing, and I'll show you that in just a second here. Then for stability, at the bottom there's just two barbell collars, a smaller one up top and then a larger one on the bottom, and obviously those are just on there with a couple of set screws, and that really has plenty of weight for the size of camera that I use, and it really helps stabilize it quite a bit. But then he sprayed it with some flat black spray paint before we wrapped on the grip tape, so to make it look a little more like it could possibly be a store-bought piece, you know, just to kind of give it a uniform color. Let me set the camera up on the tripod and I'll show you actually how I hold this when I use it. Alright, hopefully you can see me here, guys. What I've done for the purposes of the demonstration here, I've actually mounted my little Sony CyberShot camera to it. Obviously my larger camera will fit on here just as easily. It's just got the little thumb screw like any other tripod. And with this tripod head on here, once again, you can loosen this and you can actually tilt it up and down or swivel it. So it really does give you a lot of versatility as far as the angles that you can achieve. The first way that I've been using it is actually in this upright position. And what I do is I take my hand and just kind of find roughly the center of gravity of the entire unit. And then I found that if you grasp it just a bit above the center of gravity, that seems to be the most stable position. So what I'll do is I'll grab there with my right hand, and then with my left hand, I'll grab this cross brace here, and that gives it a lot of stability. And I've already used it, like when I was down at Gateway Motorsports Park, when the drag racers would come back on the return lane there, and I'd want to kind of follow along with them and get some nice, like, kind of smooth, low shots. This worked really well because as they came by, I could kind of dip down, get the camera down low, and follow them. And I was pretty happy with how it worked out, actually. The other thing you can do when you have it in this upright position is actually switch over and put your left hand in that low position, and then take your right hand and actually operate the zoom on the camera. So obviously that way you're stable, but you can also zoom in and out. Probably the ultimate setup would be to actually have the remote controls like off of a tripod or something similar, where you could mount them to this cross brace and then run that up to your camera. And that way you could have your hands in the best position, but also control the zoom on the camera. So that's something that I might look into adding to this. I think that would be kind of cool. Now, the other way that I use this actually kind of came out of necessity. I found out the other day when I was out there filming all the, you know, drag racing footage and everything, I was out there for hours, and believe it or not, these little weight plates get pretty heavy on your shoulders after a long time. So I had to kind of come up with something different. And sort of on a whim, I decided to try this. I actually took it and I found that center of gravity again. But this time I actually put it over my shoulder and just let it balance there. And once you get it to the exact balance spot, you can't feel the weight of this at all. It just kind of sits on there on its own. Then with this head being able to swivel, what you can do is actually take this, tilt it all the way back till it hits the crossbar here, And then what I was doing was actually setting the crossbar so it was about like at a 45 degree angle here. And then from here, I would just level the camera out, okay? So it'd be right in my field of vision and nice and level, but I'd have a nice handle here to put my hand on. So then with all the weight balanced on my shoulder, and then my left hand on here to stabilize it, and then I'm still left with my right hand to actually work the zoom. And it worked out really well. So, for instance, when I was, you know, filming the drag racing, I could kind of pan and like watch the burnout. And as they rolled past me pretty quickly, it was pretty easy to swivel with them and then zoom in or out as necessary to kind of keep the car in the frame and everything. And I'm really happy with it. It was actually designed to sort of be used kind of like a glide cam where you're holding it in that upright position. But I found this sort of shoulder mount way to actually, I think it actually works better. So I'll probably be using it this way a lot. And then, you know, obviously, you know, if I want to get those low gliding shots, then I can just, you know, swivel it back around and go back to using it upright. So it's a pretty versatile little piece. I'm pretty happy with it. You can look at my last video, the one from the NHRA Spring Challenge series, you know, the one with all the drag racing. I was using it that day, and that was the first time I'd ever attempted using this. So obviously I'm going to get better with it as I get a little practice. So there might be a little jitter here and there, but I mean, I was standing out there on a windy day filming fast cars, and I think it did pretty well. The only place that you'd really notice any shaking really would be when I was zooming in on the ETs out there on the scoreboard. But if you know anything about cameras, when you're zoomed in like way out there, any little movement, it's going to notice. So, but anyway, overall, I'm really happy with the setup, and I just thought Jordan did a really nice job on it, and I just wanted to kind of share it with you. So let me know what you think, and like I said, you can check out that video and see what you think of the performance of it as well. All I know is I'm happy with it, and I'm going to continue using it, and I think, you know, with practice, I'll probably get even better with it, so it should get even smoother. So, but anyway, guys, thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.